Have you ever wondered what can satellites do? What are the capabilities of a satellite? And how many satellites orbit the Earth? Hi guys, this is Prateek. Welcome to another episode of Science and Technology at Eclectic. Without satellites, our daily lives would look much different. Some of us couldn't watch television. Some of us couldn't figure out how to navigate from one place to another while traveling. Some of us could be endangered by the bad weather that we did not know was coming. Satellites are any objects that revolve around another object in the space. Some satellites are natural, while others are artificial, man-made. The moon is an example of natural satellite that orbits the Earth. However, in this episode, we are going to focus on the man-made satellites. Artificial satellites are machines that humans launch into orbit, usually around the Earth. In addition, artificial satellites can be sent to orbit other planets. For example, there are currently satellites orbiting the Moon, the Sun, and several other planets including Mercury, Venus, Mars, and Saturn. It was the Soviet Union who launched the first artificial satellite, Sputnik 1.
Then, its casing opened. The springs snapped, and the nose cone was pushed out of the way. A ball with four antennae emerged to go it alone in the darkness of space. And a radio began to send a signal back to Earth. Humanity had entered the space age.
October the 4th, 1957, and the world's press announces the miracle of the age. The Russians have successfully launched the first satellite ever to circle the Earth.
And about 4 months later, on October 4, 1957, the United States launched its first artificial satellite, the Explorer 1.
Today, a new moon is in the sky, a 23-inch metal sphere placed in orbit by a Russian rocket.
The reaction was one of astonishment and concern, for it was now known that a potential enemy was at least temporarily ahead in developing means for space travel.
President Eisenhower reassures the nation that Russia's success with the first satellite does not indicate a serious lag in American rocket research.
I promised the Secretary of the Army that we would be ready in 90 days or less.
But meanwhile, far across the country at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory, a sprawling 80-acre research and development complex in Pasadena, California, scientists and engineers were racing toward the same deadline. 90 days to put a satellite into orbit.
In Cape Canaveral, Florida, the Army's Jupiter C rocket is ready for America's second attempt to launch a space satellite. The hours-long countdown approaches zero, a moment of enormous tension, for every missile launching is still an experiment. Any one of tens of thousands of things can go wrong with catastrophic results. But all that can be done to assure perfection has been done. The moment is at hand. The countdown reaches zero. Some 3 minutes later, Explorer is in orbit, broadcasting to the world its coded scientific data. This close-up of the United States edition of Sputnik was made at a press conference with leaders of the scientific teams, Dr. Werner von Braun, Dr. James Van Allen, and Dr. William Pickering, a three-way collaboration between private industry, academic science, and the military. Cosmic ray intensity, meteor impact, solar radiation, these are the dry facts that will help carry a man ever farther into the age of space.
Since then, more than 8,000 satellites have been sent to space. Would you have ever guessed that there are that many satellites up there in the sky, traveling around the Earth over and over again? What in the world do they do up there? Why do we need so many of them? Artificial satellites are used for all sorts of purposes. Satellites like the Hubble Space Telescope, the International Space Station, and the Russian Mir Space Station help scientists in exploring space in new and exciting ways. Communication satellites help us in communicating with people all over the world. Weather satellites help us to observe the Earth from space to help predict the weather patterns. Radio and television satellites beam our favorite songs, movies, and television shows to Earth for us to enjoy. There is even a group of 27 satellites that makes up the Global Positioning System, GPS. Without these satellites, we could not use GPS devices to find our way while traveling. If you are wondering how that many satellites stay in orbit without bumping into each other, just remember that space is very well spacious. Compared to our measurements on Earth, the size of space seems infinite. Even though there is a lot of room in space, satellites are launched into orbits at different distances from Earth. Some may be as close as 150 miles above the Earth, while others may be as far away as 20,000 miles or more. Most artificial satellites orbit within 500 miles of Earth, or what scientists call low Earth orbit. These satellites have to travel very fast, approximately at the speed of about 17,000 miles per hour, to avoid being sucked back to the Earth's atmosphere. Sooner or later though, the force of gravity will pull all the objects, including artificial satellites, back to Earth. When satellites quit working, they become orbiting space junk, until gravity pulls them back to Earth. Every day, at least one piece of a space junk returns back to Earth, but we don't really notice it. Be sure to subscribe my channel, go through the playlist of amazing videos, and check out my bookstore at Amazon.